Home internet access is a critical tool for supporting educational activities at school, but gaps in student access persist. A new report from the National Center for Education Statistics explores the latest data on student internet access by geographic locale and poverty status. The report looks at differences in the percentages of 5 to 17-year-olds with home internet access in 2015. Students access the internet from home through different methods. Fixed broadband includes DSL, cable modem, fiber optic cable, and satellite internet service. Mobile broadband includes cell phone plans. Without a subscription includes individuals living in a place that provides free internet services for its residents. Finally, some homes have no access or only dial-up access. About 78% of students had access to the internet at home in 2015 through fixed broadband. 7% had access through mobile broadband. 4% had access without a subscription. And 11% of students had no access to the internet or only dial-up access. The percentage of students with different types of internet access or no internet access at home varied by poverty status. Students below the poverty threshold had lower levels of access to fixed broadband than students above the poverty threshold. A higher percentage of students in poverty also had no access or only dial-up access. Student access also varied by where they live. The percentage of students with fixed broadband access at home was highest for students in suburban areas, followed by students in cities. Students in towns and rural areas had lower levels of broadband access. A higher percentage of students in towns, rural areas, and cities reported having no internet access or only dial-up access at home compared to students in the suburbs. A higher percentage of students living in the most remote rural areas had no internet access or only dial-up. In these remote rural areas, 18% of students reported no access or only dial-up. If we focus only on students below the poverty level, we see that the percentage with fixed broadband access at home was highest for students in suburban areas, followed by students in cities, then students in towns, and was lowest for students in rural areas. The percentage of low-income students with no access or only dial-up ranges from 22% in the suburbs to 30% in rural areas. And in remote rural areas, 35% of low-income students had no internet access or only dial-up. The percentage of students living in poverty with no internet or dial-up only access was higher for students living in remote rural areas than for those living in all other locales. These data show that student internet access is a challenge for families living in poverty in many types of communities across the country, and that students in more remote rural areas face additional challenges. You can learn more about student internet access by visiting nces.ed.gov to read the full report and explore data for your state.